Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to Horizon Zero Dawn. Alright, I got back to where I was before. It seems I forgot there was a campfire over here, and that would have been my source of a checkpoint, so... whoops.
Need them soon enough.
I think what I'm going to try this time is just skirting around the absolute edge of the area. While wearing a stealth outfit. Oh, no, not allowed to go that far, I guess. They've added a bunch of those hard barriers where if you try to go through them, you get this. Nope, not allowed, loser. No cheating for you. So they really want to force you to try and circumvent this, but fortunately for us, it does not look like they've quite been able to prevent people from just bypassing that whole encounter. That up there is where we need to go. And if I remember correctly, it should be possible to Skyrim up some portion of the cliff somewhere around here.
Snow. It's not getting any warmer out here.
There we are. Oh, I think this might be... that might be a hard wall, but... we can go around this. All right. There we go. Can we make it all the way up here? We might have to do a little bit of tacking. That's a nautical maneuver, by the way. There we go. Yup. Excellent. Just bypass the whole thing. Now, you know, we can leave the stealth outfit on a little longer, I think, because there is a Stormbird up here, which we are going to need to, as I recall, either destroy or just override. I believe in this case, overriding the Stormbird here will just cause it to go away. It'll just fly off and you can get by it. I believe it will spawn when we reach the top of this rise. So I'm going to need some tie ropes. Alright, where is it? I might actually have bypassed the spot that spawns it. Yep, I think I might have.
Gaia's sacrifice. It did this. Cracked the inside of the mountain like it was an egg.
Yes, yes. Quickly now. I've prepared the way ahead for you.
So you've been in here before?
To a point. You'll see.
Poor Aloy's looking a little bit cold there. I think it may be time for us to switch to something a little bit warmer. Though, God, I hate the headdress on this equipment. I hate it so much. You know what? We can fix that. There we go. And yeah, it does appear that I completely bypassed the Stormbird spawn point.
You made a climbing path for me, but left an army of machines for me to deal with?
Since when were machines any obstacle for you? If you could fly, I wouldn't have bothered with a climbing path either.
What a nice guy.
Don't look down. Don't look down.
I mean, it really would have been nice if we could fly. It would have been great if we could use Glinthawks or Stormbirds as mounts. Hint, hint, gorilla. Sure would be great for the next game.
This is exactly the kind of place I expected to find you in, Silence.
Thank you. It's one of many workshops I've constructed over the years.
Now, he was trying to get through this door. One of the many methods he tried was rigging up a Ravager cannon to blast the door. He rigged it up with a power supply. But apparently that didn't work.
There'll be enough time later for you to ransack this place.
Right, right, of course.
For years, I tried to get through this hatch. I drilled, I burned, I blasted. But we both know that you won't have any trouble getting through.
You make it sound like I should apologize.
Not at all. It never occurred to me that the way through would not be with force, but with a key. A key in human form. The failure of imagination was mine, not yours.
Oh boy. So, Silence is this super intelligent genius. And yet it never once occurred to him that with the mountain quite literally broken apart like this, rather than going through the hatch, all he had to do was find a way around. Oh, Silence, dear friend, what are we going to do with you?
Looks like you've spent a lot of time here.
19 years ago, a great explosion destroyed this mountain. Gaia's death, your birth. The echo could be heard as far as the claim. Ash darkened the skies. How they fretted in Meridian as they tried to read this omen. The crater burned for weeks, but when it cooled, I was the first to behold what lay within. Over time, the machines closed ranks to protect it. Useful. Soon, no one dared to come here. Except me.
I thought you might actually be here this time. Actually, here.
Why? My presence is unnecessary. You don't need my help to pass through this door. You were the one born to do this, not me.
In her message, Gaia said we could restore her, but after seeing the damage, how could that be?
She said any effort to repair her must come after Hades is destroyed. I concur. Rebuilding the terraforming system now might allow Hades to use it as a weapon. Because of Gaia's sacrifice, it has been forced to search for means that are less convenient.
But do you think it's even possible to restore Gaia?
You know what the Cauldrons are capable of. How they fabricate any technology necessary to create a machine. By the same principle, it should be possible to replicate every technology necessary to repair Gaia. But that would take years. We're counting the time we have left by the hour.
Fair point. All right, I'm going in.
It's time for me to head in.
Yes. When you find the Master Override, you will gain the power to defeat Hades. Everything depends on you.
Oh boy, I love it when everything depends on me. Alright, now, before we head in, there is one thing I absolutely need to take care of. because the fashion is bothering me. That bothers me even more, to be honest. As does that. Gosh, are there no face paints? No, I guess not. I was gonna say, are there no face paints that match the outfit, which don't look completely goofy and terrible?
Genetic identity confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. You are clear to proceed.
Oh, look, it's Sylens.
Yes?
I need to get going.
Hey, Sylens. See ya. All right, now there should be... Well, there is. I know for a fact that there is. The last remaining power cell for the Shieldweaver armor in a room a little bit further in.
Logging arrivals, Shan Margo.
Welcome to Frozen Hell. Population 10?
11 counting Gaia.
Don't count your chicken embryos before they're incubated, hon. She's still firing up. Be a while before you eat that omelet.
I'm vegan,
Mind
Travis. You think we'd worked in the same secret base long enough for you to notice?
We weren't scheduled to shack up here for another 3 weeks. You realize...
Ah! Well, I didn't mean to skip that. I'll have to go play it again, I guess.
Logging arrivals.
Fine.
Logging arrivals. Shan Margo.
Welcome to Frozen Hell. Population 10.
11 counting Gaia.
Don't count your chicken embryos before they're incubated, hon. She's still firing up. Be a while before you eat that omelet.
I'm vegan, Travis. You think we'd worked in the same secret base long enough for you to notice?
We weren't scheduled to shack up here for another 3 weeks. You realize I just lost 350 kilos of pre-code smut comics in transit.
Wait, actual physical media? Why didn't you have it digitized?
Can't beat the feel of physical media on your fingers. And in here, we ain't gonna be touching a whole lot else. Figured I was gonna pass the time archiving them. What about you?
Me? Work, I guess. My task queue stretches out for, like, 3 years. There's a lot of sharp edges to round off. After that, I hadn't really thought about it.
Oh, you will. You're what, 30? Reckon you'll be the one turning the lights off at the end. Food for thought, huh, vegan?
This sucks forever.
Nah, not forever. Just the rest of your life.
Well, thanks, Travis. That was a great way to cheer Margo up. I bet she really appreciated that. And felt so much better afterward. Yes, Travis is definitely that guy. Alright, well... That power cell should be in here. Oh, no. There we go.
Huh. A fifth power cell. They must fit somewhere.
So that is indeed the last one. Now I need to get back up. Come on. There we go. So that I can go down. Yeah, that explosion sure made a mess of the place, didn't it?
Guess that's my way across.
I'm sure it's fine.
Don't think, Aloy. Just do it.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
Yep, that's a long way down.
It's, held like this for 19 years, right?
Well...
Don't answer.
But...
Glad that's over.
Fortunately, it looks like we're safe now. Alright. Yeah, I guess this is just a straight path for the time being. There we go.
Not this way. Maybe further up the shaft.
And she is right, but there are... I thought there were a couple of items down here. I guess it was just that supply crate. There we are.
This must have been where they lived. What's left of it? Once this was all enclosed by rock and metal.
Sure was. Was one big explosion, huh? Okay, I guess this is, again, just a straight path. I thought for some reason there were more rooms on the sides here. Ah, there we go.
Record. I just woke up. I see the numbers, but can't make out the time. I was dreaming of... I was giving a lecture in Q Hall. Maybe it was something more shamanistic. I don't know. An audience of shadowy faces under a blank open sky. I told them the world ended with a bang. A plague of robots. But the last humans. We went out, not with a whimper, but a whisper. You know, in caves, ending like we started, huddled around a flickering glow. The heads of state, the Fortune Fives, the leaders, and lottery winners, and life cults, all of them buried in their little shelters. Some believing they'll live it out some way, somehow, or Elysium, or us here at Gaia Prime, no different. A multitude of tiny societies taking hold, flaring, dying. Some will be beautiful, some horrific, and none of them matter. Short-term civilizations. One last gasp before the long-held breath. Before I wake up, I know the audience is gone. I'm talking to myself, to a quiet planet, a barren sphere. Just Gaia and her long, long dreaming. I hope she won't be lonely.
Gaia being lonely would be the least of our problems. Or hers, based on the way things have turned out. I believe we need to go... No, I guess not. I think it's left first, then. somewhere in here there should be another data point from whoever it is that lived in this room. No, I guess not. I thought there was. There are a few scattered throughout this area, but I guess none in here. No, I guess we need to go right. This should be Elizabeth's room, I think. There we go. Nope.
Evacuation happened so fast. No time to think things through. No time for goodbyes. There were lines in the medical ward. I told Tom Paik I'd be with him when he went under. But there was one last shipment of Paradisaity zygotes I could get processed if I rushed. I'm still angry at him for forcing me to choose. Angry at myself for... Well, he died alone. And I didn't get the bloody birds of paradise saved either. All the time left in the world now to think. Gaia Prime's locks are sealed. Elysium sealed up, safe and sound. A distance of miles, but it might as well be on the other side of the galaxy. All the betas and gammas and support staff living their lives. If I hadn't been an alpha, if things had gone differently, I could have been there. Instead, I'm spending the rest of my unnatural life in here with people I don't even like. And without the one I would have gladly spent my life with. Given a chance. 2 hours since I signed off on the final executables and I'm already a bitter old man bitching to his focus. There's a thought for future generations.
Interesting. Now, Charles Ronson was the one who took over for Tom Paik after he finished dealing with the initial programming of Artemis. But Charles also mentioned something about being trapped in here with people he didn't even like, minus the one person he did like. Huh, I wonder what that could mean. Perhaps we'll find out if we press on. Jeez, I don't remember this path being quite so...
Elizabeth's room.
Oh, there we go.
I know it. She didn't even get a chance to unpack. These are her journals. Elizabeth's journals. And they're all destroyed?
Scan them. The Focus can rebuild them, but the process is slow. To us, it seems a powerful device, but its engine is tiny and limited.
How slow?
Days, weeks, years. Concern yourself with stopping Hades and extending the future, and you might live long enough to hear them.
Gaia Journals, Dr. Elizabeth Sobeck. Solid-state storage devices. Cursory scan includes severe data corruption from impact and exposure damage. Yeah, that'll corrupt some data, all right. All right, I believe that's the way we need to go, but... Oh, yeah, okay, no getting through there. Yes, indeed, we do need to go through here. Those journals we just collected, by the way, those will automatically... be defragmented by the Focus. I believe... Well, they appear in here somewhere. They become data points Oh, there we go. There they are. So what will happen is these files, which say damaged under repair, the ones that are part of Elizabeth's journals, when you pass certain points in the remainder of this quest and the remainder of the final quest of the game, the final battle, these will become unlocked and you'll be able to read them.
Elizabeth, what is this?
Not something good from the looks of it. Let's see.
This is Charles Rodson. I'm logging this 6 hours after final deployment of Gaia Prime. This morning, an access port seal malfunctioned. Gaia Prime's port seals were designed to close with a seam of less than 2 millimeters. But this one closed with a 10-millimeter gap. Enough for an energy signature to bleed through. Enough for the swarm to detect this facility. Enough for Gaia to be discovered and destroyed. Enough to end the future we worked so hard to make possible. Unless the hatch servos were manually re-engaged from the outside. I'm now switching to a recording of the event.
Well, I'm not going out there. Not what I signed up for. Either we send someone out, or all of this was for nothing.
It should be Liz's decision.
So when is she going to get here?
She said 5 minutes. You don't think...
Oh, no. Okay, everyone. I've repaired the seal. Gaia?
Seal closure at 1.4 millimeters. Confirmed.
Elizabeth, no. We'll find a way to bring you back in.
It's not gonna happen. The swarm's too close. Really. It's all right. Gaia's complete. She'll take care of things from here on out. That's what she does.
Not like this. There's so much we...
Guys, you know me. I'm no good at endings. At letting things end. So, let's not.
So... Happy trails, Liz. And, see you around.
Yeah. Take care of each other, all right?
Liz.
I'm okay with this. I want to go home. Goodbye.
That was the last transmission of Elizabeth Sobeck. She gave everything for the hope of life on this planet. And we are all in her debt.
Oh look, there's Sylens. So now after watching that holographic recording, these data points appear on the table. And Sylens appears right here, but we're going to have to save the remainder of these conversations for next time. So thank you all very much for joining me, and I look forward to seeing all of you then. Take care, everybody.